Welcome back to the Morgan Streetman Show, and we're going to keep it rolling with some more stories on Afghanistan. Hey, as we told you the last couple of weeks, you need to keep thinking about this because you're going to start to see some stories creeping out about where did all our military equipment wind up? You know, we left tens of billions of dollars of equipment, tanks, armored personnel carriers, Humvees, helicopters, including Black Hawk helicopters, highly sophisticated Black Hawk helicopters, airplanes, as well as a bunch of guns, rockets, grenades, and other personnel-type weapons. So we left all that in Afghanistan for some reason. I mean, the waste is just unbelievable. I mean, did they leave that so we could just buy all new ones for next time? I mean, why didn't we have an orderly withdrawal? This didn't sneak up on us.
Or at least destroy it.
But you destroy it, you're doing the same thing. It's largesse for the military-industrial complex that President Eisenhower warned us about, you know, 70 years ago or whatever it was. So, nevertheless, this equipment, this materiel is winding up in our enemy's hands. You will see that. First of all, you've heard China is supposed to be taking over Bagram Air Force Base. I mean, isn't that beautiful? I think we spent a couple of billion dollars building Bagram Air Force Base. Now the Chinese are going to take it over. Guess what else? I'm sure the Chinese are going to get those Black Hawk helicopters that they would like to reverse engineer. Find out exactly what's in them, exactly how they work, exactly what kind of systems we use, because that's what the Chinese do. That's how they built their military to begin with, was stealing our military secrets. That goes back to the Clinton years, for those of you that can remember that, when Clinton turned over our satellite and missile technology to China. So the Chinese are going to get some of our sophisticated aircraft, reverse engineer it. But guess what? BBC reporters are now reporting that the Humvees themselves have already ended up in Iran. Iran's already got a bunch of the Humvees, and they got photographs to support that report. So this material, you don't think the Taliban, who's holding our people hostage on tarmac, saying, hey, we're not going to let planes take off unless you give us money, you don't think they're taking the equipment and selling it for whatever they can get for it? They're trying to raise funds so they can run a government, because they don't know how to run an actual functioning state, a modern state. They know how to run a state back, you know, 1,300 years ago, but they don't know how to run a state today. So they're going to sell this stuff off to all of our enemies, and our enemies are going to be enriched by it. And why did we leave it there? It doesn't make any sense. Why did we do that? Just like, why are we spending all this money on these refugees who are going to become, some of them probably, domestic terrorists? Right? All right. How about this story? Apparently, and this is being reported again by the Washington Post, for those of you that want to hear some mainstream media behind the story, a hospital near the Dulles Expo Center in Northern Virginia has had to turn away Americans. Has had to turn away Americans because there are too many Afghans in the hospital. So we hear all these stories, by the way, which are fake news, about people being turned away from other hospitals because COVID patients and people, remember that story about people overdosing on ivermectin, horse dewormer, and now people with gunshots, Americans with gunshots, can't get medical care? That story that Rolling Stone put out that was total fake news and has been proved to be total fake news because the hospital system came out and said this is totally fake. By the way, I drove by a hospital up in Brooksville over the weekend, and they had on their sign, 0 minute wait in the ER. So these overwhelmed ERs, overwhelmed by COVID, they just don't exist. I know there's a lot of people that had to go to the hospital for COVID here in Florida. And I know it was tight. Believe me, I know it was tight. But people still could get in. The hospital still functioned. But now here we read, in Northern Virginia, up in Dulles, Virginia, they actually had to turn Americans away because the hospital was totally overrun by Afghan refugees with all of their problems that they came over with. And, of course, the offices of Senators Tim Kaine and Mark Warner. God, could you imagine if those were your two senators? Tim Kaine and Mark Warner? I mean, somebody shoot me. Those are terrible senators to have. But they're aware of and monitoring the situation. Yeah, I bet they are. They're part of the problem. I bet they are monitoring it. Okay, one more story about Afghanistan, then we'll move on because we do have some other interesting stuff to cover for you. But did you hear this one? You remember that guy, Bo Bergdahl? The guy, the Army guy who just walked off?
The deserter.
Off? Yeah, the deserter, right. Who we traded five maximum level terrorists, top level terrorists, out of Gitmo to get back an Army deserter. This was back in 2014. President Obama did this, okay? Talk about selling out the U.S. Let's give them back their terrorist leadership. And by the way, how do you think, how hardened do you think these guys were after over a decade in Gitmo? I mean, they were pretty hardened. They've probably all been subject to enhanced interrogation methods like waterboarding and other things. But now, you want to know? Now they've announced, the Taliban has announced just last Tuesday that they've appointed the four of these five individuals as top-level government ministers. So four of these five-level apex terrorists have been appointed as Taliban government ministers. And we could give you their names, but we're not going to bother with that. You can look.
But they are bad
guys. They're bad guys. They serve time in Gitmo. We traded them away for an army deserter, and now they are in top leadership in the Taliban. And somebody explain that to me. Why does that make it? How does that make any sense? It simply doesn't.
Thank you for listening to the Morgan Streetman Show. We hope you enjoyed what you heard, and if you did, please click like and subscribe to help us out. And remember that we recommend that you exercise your brain at least once a week.